Hello everyone, welcome. Let's see some different problems on percentages. So problem number one is 1.14 expressed as a percent of 1.9 is, so 1.14 is expressed as a percent of 1.9. So 1.14 divided by 1.9 into 100. To express it as a percent, we have to multiply by 100, which implies if we divide and multiply and divide this term, and we get the whole number as 114 divided by 190 into 100. If we cancel this, we get the answer 60%. Here we multiply the term by multiply and divide by 100, we get 114 by 190. Next problem, Kamal has 160 toffees. He gave 5% toffees to Ravi, 15% toffees to Anita, and 1/4 of the toffees to Gagan. How many toffees are left with Kamal after the distribution? So total number of toffees is 160. From 160 toffees, Kamal gave 5% to Ravi, 15% to Anita, and 1/4 to Jagan. So by adding the percentage of Ravi and Anita, we get 20%. 20% is nothing but 1/5. So 160 of 1/5, total number of toffees of 1/5 is nothing but 32. So to Ravi and Anita, Kamal gave 32 toffees. Next, for Jagan, 1/4 of 160 is 40. So to Jagan, Kamal gave 40 toffees. So the total number of toffees he distribute is 32 plus 40 equal to 72. So the question is, how many toffees are left? So we have to subtract the 72 from the total number of toffees. So 160 minus 72 equal to 88. So the option is C. Problem number 3. If it cost rupees 1 to photocopy a sheet of paper, however 2% discount is allowed on all photocopies done after first 1000 sheets, how much it will cost to copy 5000 sheets of paper? So what given is, it costs rupee 1 to photocopy a sheet of paper, and 2% discount is allowed on all photocopies done after first 1000 sheets. So first 1000 sheets, if we want to find the cost of 5000, we have to add 4000 with 1000, we get 5000 into, for every 1000 sheets 2% discount is allowed. 2% discount means for 100, 98 divided by 100. So if we cancel this, we get the answer 3920 plus 1000. This is 3920 plus 1000, that is equal to 4920. So it will cost ₹4920 to copy 5000 sheets of paper. So the answer option is D. Next problem, how many liters of pure acid are there in 8 liters of a 20% solution? This is easy. So what is 8 liters of 20% means 20 divided by 100. So you cancel 5, 4, that is 8 by 5, which is equal to nothing but 1.6. So the answer is C. Let's see the next problem. In a class of 65 students and 4 teachers, each student got sweets that are 20% of the total number of students, and each teacher got sweets that are 40% of the total number of students. How many sweets are there? So in a class of 65 students, so students, teachers, there are total number of, in a class of 65 students, here 4 teachers, each student got sweets that are 20% of the total number of students. So 65 into 20 divided by 100, and each teacher got sweets that are 40% of the total number of students. So 65 into each teacher got sweets that are 40% of the total number of students. Total number of students 65, and 40% is nothing but 2 by 5. So what is the answer? 2553, which is equal to 13, and here 26. So to find how many sweets are there, so number of students is 65 into 13 plus here 26 into 4 teachers, we get 65 into 13 is 845 plus 26 into 4 is 104. The total number of sweets is 949. So the total number of sweets is 949. If we add the total number of students into the percentage, we get plus. Here the percentage value is, for 40% we get 26 into 4 teachers. The value is 845. Here the value is 104. So if we add this, we get 949. So totally there are 949 sweets. The next problem is, a student scores 55% of marks in 8 papers of 100 marks each. He scores 15% of his total marks in English. How much does he score in English? So what is given in the question is, a student scores 55% in 8 papers of 100 marks. That is, 55% of 100 marks is 55 divided by 100 into 100 equal to 55 marks. So the student scores 55 marks in 8 papers. So the total marks obtained is 55 into 8 equal to 440. 55 is the mark he score in each paper. The total number of paper is 8. So 55 into 8 is 440. The question is, he scores 15% of his total marks. The total marks is 440. So 15% of total marks is 440 is equal to 15 divided by 100 into 440 equal to 0 3 2 22 66. So 15% of his total marks in English. So how much does he score in English? He scores 66 marks in English. So the option is C. Next problem, A, B, C and D have rupees 40, rupees 50, rupees 60 and rupees 70 respectively. When they go to visit a fair, A spends rupees 18, B spends rupees 21, C spends rupees 24 and D spends rupees 27. Who has done the highest expenditure proportionate to his resources? So they give A, B, C and D have rupees 40, 50, 60 and 70 respectively. So A's money is 40 rupees, B's money is 50 rupees, C's money is 60 and D is 70. Out of 40, A spends 18 rupees. Out of 50, B spends 21 rupees. Out of 60, C spends 24 rupees. And out of 70, D spends 27 rupees. So, to find the percentage, multiply every term into 100. So we get 0, 2, 5, 2, 9, 40%, 45%, 0, 2, 42%, 0, 3, 5, 8, 40%, 0, 38.5%. So the highest expenditure is here 45%. So the answer is A. A has the highest expenditure proportionate to his resources. Next problem. 40% of 60% of 3/5 of a number is 504. What is the 25% of 2/5 of that number? So as I write the question, I write the data is given in the question as let the number be x. We have to find that number. So let the number be x. X into 40% of 60% of 3/5. So 40% is nothing but 2/5 of 60% is nothing but 3/5 of 3/5 of a number is x is 504. So we get if we solve this we get 2 2 4 5 2 3 3 8 3 4 3 2 3 8. So next what we get is 5 into 5 into 5 is 125. X into 125, x into 125 into 28 into, what is the question? What is 25% of 2/5 of that number? So the number into 25% is nothing but 1/4 into 2/5. What is 25% of 2/5 of that number? 25% of 2/5 of that number is equal to 5 into 25 4 7 4. So 25 into 7 into 2 equal to 350. So the number is 350. The answer is 350. Next problem, if 75% of a number is added to 75, then the result is the number itself, the number is. So if we add a number, a 75% of a number, 75% of a number is added to 75, we get the number itself. So if we get the number itself, we have to check the options. So for consider the first option 50. So 50 75% is nothing but 3/4. 75% of a number is added to 75, which is equal to the same number. First, we generally write a number is of 75% is added to 75 is equal to the same number. If I put the option A for x, so 50 into 3/4 plus 75 equal to 50. So if I get what 225. So 25 into 3 is 75 divided by 2 plus 75 equal to 50, which implies 112.5 equal to 50. This is not equal, so the option A is wrong. Similarly, the option B is also wrong. So if we take option C, 300 into 3/4 plus 75 equal to 300. So we get 4 7 28 4 5 are, so 75 into 3 is 225 plus 75 equal to 300, which implies 300 equal to 300. So the answer is 300. We go with the option C. So the option C is correct. So we did not want to check the option D. Let us see the next problem. The sum of two numbers is 28/25 of the first number. The second number is what percentage of the first? So the sum of two numbers, so we did not know the number, so we put x. Sum means addition, so sum of two numbers is 28 divided by 25 of the first number. The first number is x, so into x. So divide both sides by y, we get divide by y on both sides, x by y plus 1 equal to x by y into 28/25. So 1 equal to 28x/25y minus x by y. If we simplify this, we get 3x/25y, which implies x by y equal to 25/3. So what we have to find is second number is what percentage of the first. So second number is what percentage? Second number is nothing but y. So y is equal to 3 and x is equal to 25. So second number is what percent of first number into, to find percentage, multiply by 100, we get 12%. So the option is A. Next problem, two numbers A and B are such that the sum of 5% of A and 4% of B is 2/3 of the sum of 6% of A and 8% of B. Find the ratio of A is to B. So given is two numbers A and B. So A and B are such that the sum of 5% of A, so A into 5 divided by 100, the sum of means plus 4% of B, so B into 4 divided by 100 is equal to 2/3 of, so 2/3 of sum of 6% of A, so 6A/100 plus 8B/100, 8% of B. If we solve this, we get the ratio. So cancel this 100 and multiply this 3 this side to here. So 5a into 3 15a plus 4 into 3 12b equal to 12a plus 16b. So 15 minus 12 is 3a, 16 minus 12 is 4b, which implies a by b equal to 4 by 3, that is 4 is to 3. So the option is D. Next problem, 25% of Reena's yearly income is equal to 75% of Anubhav's monthly income. If Anubhav's yearly income is 2,40,000, what is Reena's monthly income? So here what is given is Reena's yearly income is 25%, that means 1 by 4 is equal to 75% of Anubhav's monthly income. Anubhav's monthly income into 75% means 3 by 4. If Anubhav's yearly income is 2,40,000, Anubhav's yearly income is 2,40,000. His monthly income is divided by 12, we get 20,000. So Anubhav's yearly income is this, his monthly income is 20,000. So if we substitute this here, Reena's yearly income into 1 by 4 equal to 20,000 into 3 by 4, we get 5,000. 5 threes are 15. So here we get RY equal to 5 threes are 15,000 into 4, 60,000. So this is Reena's yearly income. If we want to find Reena's monthly income, we have to divide it by 12. We get 5,000. So Reena's monthly income is rupees 5,000. So here the option is not here. So the answer is none of these. Next problem. In an examination, X accused 58% of marks and Y accused 105 marks less than X. If the maximum marks were 700, then what percentage of marks did Y secure? So here this is the examination. 0 is the minimum mark and 700 is the maximum mark. X accused 58% mark. So the total marks is 700, then there are 7 subjects. So 58 into 7 equal to 406. So the marks obtained by X is 406 and Y secures 105 marks less than X. So 406 minus 105 is 301. So what percentage of marks did Y secure? So percentage, we have to find the percentage. So 301 divided by total marks 700 into 100, we get 43%. So the answer is B, 43%. Next problem, Nupur invests rupees 89,856, which is 26% of her annual income, in mutual funds. What is her monthly income? So Nupur invests rupees 89,856, which is 26% of her annual income in mutual funds. What is her monthly income? To find monthly income, divided by 12. So if we solve this, we get the answer. So 213, 4928. So next we solve 4311232. Next 3 3 7 4 4. Cancel this by 13, we get 288. So 288 into 100 equal to 28800 rupees. So her monthly income is 28,800. So the option is B. Next problem, the value of which of the following fractions is less than 20%? So we have to check the options one by one. So 5 by 6, option A, 5 by 6 into 100 is 83%. Next option B, 2 by 3 into 100 is 66.66%. 2 by 5 means 40%. And 1 by 4 means 25%. So these are all greater than 20. So the option, the only option is 2 by 11. 2 by 11 into 100 is nothing but 18%. So the option is E. Next problem, the difference between 54% of a number, 54% of a number and 26% of the same number is 22526. What is 66% of that number? So the number be, let the number be X. So 54% of a number is X into 54 divided by 100 and 26% of the same number. So the difference between means subtraction, X into 26 divided by 100 is 22526. So we get 54 minus 26 is nothing but 28 divided by 100 into X equal to 22526. So which implies 22526 into 100 divided by 28, we get X. So if we cancel this, we solve this, we get. And also, what is the question? What is 66% of that number? So into 66 divided by 100. So if we solve this, we get 2 4 3 3 7 2 7 3 2 1 8 2 1 6 0 9. If we multiply this, we get X equal to 5 3 0 9 7. So the option is D. Thank you.